Hey guys, how you doing? It's Kevtech here, bringing another video on information technology. I hope you're having a good day. Happy Saturday. And today I want to look at jobs for IT support helpdesk. Obviously, you know my channel, you know what to do. Rate, comment, subscribe, give me a thumbs up. Really appreciate it. So today we're going to look at jobs again. And I'm going to show you what they're asking for, what they specifically need in their job environment. So we're going to go over two, three jobs. I don't want to go over too many jobs. I tried making this video and I ended up going too long with it. So I'm going to try showing it a lot more, because I know that I could do that. All right, so let me share my screen and go over that real quick. So share screen three. All right, so the first job we're gonna look at is this one, Microsoft Windows Helpdesk. And it says here that they're asking for remote software technology. So you have to be proficient with how to remote in. So if you know how to use Team Viewer, log me in. There is NinjaOne, there's AnyDesk, there's BombGuard. There's like so many applications out there that you could use to remote in. I'm not sure what they use in this work environment. I think SplashTop's another one. So you need to understand how to use remote applications, remote software technologies, virtual private network, which is your VPN. So you're gonna have users using VPN, whether that's, I'm not sure if it's Cisco VPN, maybe Zscaler, I don't know. Depends on the work environment. And obviously they're paying $55 to $65 dollars an hour, and they're remote. And this is general networking firewall troubleshooting. So that could be anything from troubleshooting network issues on the local machine. I'm not sure if it's troubleshooting network issues outside the local machine of the end user or the customer. Then firewall troubleshooting could be maybe you have access to firewall to make firewall changes. I'm not sure if that's also, again, part of Zscaler, or maybe they use Cisco Meraki. I'm not sure what they use, but going based on this, I don't know what technologies they use for networking. Windows troubleshooting, obviously, understanding how to troubleshoot an application, not just uninstall, reinstall an application. Anyone could do that. Obviously, you could run a repair application. You can make some changes on the registry as well. If someone's having a weird IT issue, you may have to contact the vendor themselves in order to troubleshoot the issue that they're having on their Windows machine. And then here, printer troubleshooting would be like if they're having issues with the printer, how do you troubleshoot it? Obviously, you could go into services on your printer, on your local machine, and you go to print services, and you go to print Spooner services, and you could stop it and start it, and that would actually fix one of the printer issues. The printer is not printing, or the printer's not showing up. You could remove and re-add the printer. Could be many reasons why the printer is not working. Could be because our VPN is not connected, because they have to connect to VPN in order to access the printer. Could also be the problem would be is the IP address has changed on the printer. It could be so many reasons why it's doing that. Office 365 cloud applications. Office 365 is very generic. It could be anything from troubleshooting Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, from troubleshooting Exchange Admin Center. I don't see Exchange Admin Center mentioned on this. So I am just going to assume it's regular Office 365 with Outlook issues and Excel issues. And I've done a lot of videos on this, which could be like safe mode, add-ons, plugins that people have on their computer for Excel, Word, PowerPoint, Outlook. Cloud applications could mean anything. Maybe you're signing a cloud application using Microsoft Intra. I'm not sure how their environment is set up. Like if I go to intra.microsoft.com, maybe they have a section here for applications where they actually have applications here, and you have to manually assign the applications by a security group. I'm not sure how that works. So it really depends on the work environment, right? And then G Suite Admin, I've gone over G Suite Admin before on my videos. If you have not watched that video, I recommend you go watch that video. So for G Suite Admin, you know how to create user accounts. You know how to create distribution accounts. You need to understand how to use GAM for Google Admin Workspace. So GAM is Google Admin Workspace. This allows you to run the command line, makes it a lot seamless. It's Linux Mac OS X terminal. You open up GAM, and GAM allows you to run commands to manage your domain and user accounts in a quickly and easily matter. So if you know how to use GAM on your machine, it's a lot easier for you to manage these user accounts. I use GAM in my current job, so this will make your life a lot easier. Instead of you trying to manually do it by click, 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 you could just run it in the terminal. And I have not made a video on this, by the way. So, but just GAM is a very interesting thing. All right. And here is just a GAM overview because people are asking about GAM. You go to the Google Admin Console. You sign in. You download the GitHub. Download GAM in GitHub. You extract it. You have the JSON file. You run GAM for the first time. How to run it. You have a common command. Get domain information. Get your domain information for your specific domain account for your work environment. You have the ability to sync group memberships. You have the ability to execute commands and stuff like that. So something good to know. It definitely is very helpful. You got to be a critical thinker. You have to provide general desktop user hardware support troubleshooting, troubleshoot general troubleshooting network issues, et cetera, et cetera. So it doesn't say how much experience you need to have for this job. If you have 1 year of experience, I would apply to this job. That's just my opinion. All right. We'll go to the next job. Let's look at, trying to stay away from New York because New York pays a lot more than other places. They keep getting New York jobs showing up over here. So just go to the next page. Technical support analyst. This is Denver, Colorado. All right, cool. They have vision pay, pay holidays, life insurance, blah, blah, blah. They require a bachelor's degree or foreign equivalent requirement. Any relevant certifications will add advantage. They're asking for AWS experience. So at this point, what the hell is the pay for this? Doesn't even say the pay. Weekend as needed. Asking for AWS. This is not even entry level at this point. They're asking for AWS SQL experience. There is no pay anywhere on this. So I am going to skip this one and look for another job. Because that is not entry level. Helpdesk analyst in Illinois. Okay. See what we have here. Illinois. Pay time off. Solution reimbursement. Mileage rate. Or so you're expected to probably drive and travel. Pay time off. Retirement savings. Okay. So support software, hardware, systems, including diagnosing and resolving issues with operating systems, Windows, iOS, Android, Mac applications. Manage Office 365 mailbox, distribution group, share mailbox. This is the stuff that I normally do or I know I'm familiar with. So this definitely looks like a help desk role. Provide remote support when possible. Communicate effectively with users. So obviously, you got to remote into their machines. You have to know how to answer phone calls and helping the user while being by remoting into their machine. So you must be good with customer service. You must be good with troubleshooting hardware issues, assembling, disassembling computers, assembly, disassembling monitors, assembling, disassembling printers. That makes sense. Collaborate with departments. So you can work with different departments and help one another. Ensure you're following compliance with HIPAA and other regulations require an IT responsibility. So you're probably going to have HIPAA training, most likely on your first week in your job if you get this job. You have to be good with customer service. You have to understand general knowledge of HR, finance, and CRM systems. If the ability to troubleshoot escalations is needed, ability to translate technical information to non-technical. So you have to know how to translate technical jargon to non-technical people. Make it super non-technical as possible. So you're going to be dealing with end users that are not tech savvy. So you have to know how to talk to them in a non-tech way. It's basically what this is saying. Learn how to translate technical jargon into non-tech words. You have to be good with troubleshooting Windows 11, Windows 10, iOS, Android, Active Directory, Office 365, Exchange, VPN, Virtual Private Network, DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, DNS, Domain Name Server, and other relevant technologies. So this job looks perfect for someone that just finished a degree in school and has a bachelor's degree. I would apply to this job. It says 3 to 5 years of experience. If you have a bachelor's degree, I would apply anyway and see what happens. You have to know about Active Directory, file and folder permissions. I got an over NTFS permission, so you have to know how to do this. So if you set up a work and lab environment, you can learn how to do this. And you have to have experience with customer service, support ticket management, diagnostics, and issue resolution. Yeah, and then to be able to lift some stuff up. So this job's not bad. It's not bad. The only thing I see here that is a problem here is the pay. How much are you paying? I think you may have to go to the website and figure out how that works. Let me go here. Yeah, I have to sign in. All right, that's fine. I'm going to sign in. I'm gonna go to one more job and they'll call it a day after that. If you guys want me to, if you guys want me to make more videos on this, let me know. I'd be more than happy to make more videos on this. I'm going to skip Brooklyn, New York. All right, let's go to New York one. That's fine. IT tech administration support. All right, 50 to 60K, Monday through Friday, pay time off, health insurance, retirement plan. Provide desktop support, resolve technical issues or end users in a timely manner. That makes sense. Assist with wiring, setting up computers. So you have to know how to do hardware setup. Analyze system performance, implement remedies to improve efficiency. That's fine. Assist with help desk operations, addressing users' inquiries and providing solutions. Manage user accounts and permissions through Active Directory. So you have to know about Active Directory. Support network administration tasks, including monitoring, maintaining network devices. That's fine. Troubleshoot issues and provide necessary support, administration support as needed. Then we need to create documentations on solutions and updates in a knowledge base for future reference. If you were to leave, God forbid you were to leave the company and you have all that knowledge that you learned from the job environment, they want you to create documentation on that. So if you leave, that documentation is there for them. And you have to do a drug test. That's fine. You have to have experience. You have to have proven experience in desktop support or similar IT role. Strong understanding of ServiceNow. You could definitely learn ServiceNow for free. If you get ServiceNow developer program, you should be able to, I think it's called developer program. I think, let me just double check. I think it's called ServiceNow developer. Yeah. ServiceNow developer. I clicked on the wrong one. It's this one. And you should be able to start building. You should be able to get access to it. This is free. You don't got to pay anything. This is absolutely free. So you could sign up for that in order to get that experience on a ticketing system. Proficiency in analyzing technical problems, implementing effective solutions. Familiarity with Active Directory is there again. You have to be experienced with Linux operating systems. Highly desired. So I would set up a Ubuntu VM and just start learning about Linux. Knowledge of network administration principles. You have to be good with customer service. Again, customer service is very important. You have to be able to work independently and work as part of a team in a fast-paced environment. Interesting. So network admin, desktop support. This is Jamaica, New York area. You have to relocate. You have to be able to live around this area, and you have to be in person. Now, this is not a bad job. It's not bad, not bad. If I have 1 year of experience, or I have 0 year of experience, but I have a solid home lab, I would apply for this job. That's just my opinion. I know as asking for some experience, I still apply anyway. That's just my opinion. So I'll stop sharing. So that's it for jobs. If you, like I said, if you want me to make more videos on this, let me know. I just want to look at jobs before I start getting into the technical stuff, because December is coming up. I'm going to start going into technical stuff. Like I'm going to do some walk me throughs and try hack me and a bunch of other stuff. Anyway, with that being said, I hope you guys have a wonderful Saturday and take care. Bye. Peace.